Alice this morning?
Good.
She's safe. She's good. She's a good girl. It's okay. It's like, oh, okay. Well, we get to play Stomp the Pastor this morning. Somebody gets to put something in this box up here. And I get to try and make a children's message out of it. I have no idea what's in the box. She does. Okay, they must put it in there. Anyway, so whatever's in there is what I have to use to make a children's message. So let's see what I've been given this morning. You may or may not get dinner.
It was super cool because she bottle flipped it in there. It was awesome.
Wow. Oh, look at that. Hand sanitizers. Hands, and stuff to put on your hands, and it sanitizes your hands so that, you know, once you, when you touch icky gross stuff, it is used to wash away that dirt and grime and whatever else, right? Yeah. I don't like the whatever else is what I don't like. Well, you know, as we live our lives, we get a lot of dirty, gross, disgusting stuff in the world around us. Sometimes, well, we just kind of stink of the world. There is one thing, though, that washes over us and that makes us whiter than snow, cleaner than a hand sanitizer could make us. Actually, what happens is once we're washed in this, we are actually made righteous. Can you believe that? Not something we do, but it's something that Jesus did for you and you and you and all the rest of us here. You see, it is in and through Jesus' blood on the cross that we are washed away from that icky, gross stuff, all that gross stuff that's on us. And we are washed in his blood. And that's the only way to get rid of, well, okay, let's call it what it is, sin. Okay, we're going to call it sin. Okay, that icky, gross stuff is called sin. And it's in and through Jesus that our sins are washed away. We are forgiven. And we get to go to heaven. And it's just awesome. But unless we have the sanitizer, unless we have the washing over us, the blood of Jesus washes over us, accepting Jesus as our Lord and Savior, well, I guess, you know, we're just going to remain dirty and sinful. So, would you guys want your friends to stay dirty and sinful? No, I wouldn't want my friends to stay dirty and simple either. So what do you think you can do to help them not be dirty and simple?
Tell them about God.
Yeah.
Nice job, Nolan.
Nice job, Nolan. Nolan used Shaniqua as a puppet and said, tell them about God. What else do you think we could do?
Bring them to church once in a while.
That'd be fun. Another good one, Nolan. Nolan is speaking to the girls this morning, so he's got all the answers. Fist bump. Yeah, okay. Invite them. You know what? When we're good to them, really nice to friends and stuff who may not know Jesus, and they're like, why are you so nice? Well, you can tell them, well, I'm nice because I've got Jesus in my heart, and I got joy, and I'm happy, and I'm really psyched. So there's many ways that even you guys, as young as you are, they're all kids up here. We're all kids, I guess, kids of the King. But remember that, though, that we're saved, we're washed clean in the blood of Jesus. And it's good that we share that with others so that they too can be washed clean. Because God wants everyone, young, old, in between. God wants everyone to accept his son as his Lord, their Lord and Savior, and be washed clean. He doesn't want anyone to not have that opportunity, because he loves us that much. Can we say a prayer to one another this morning? Dear God, we thank you that you sent Jesus into our lives and into the world so that we can be washed free of sin. Lord, we thank you for that free gift that you give us through Jesus. Help us to share that with our friends who may not know Jesus. Help us to live that life and be that joyful that they see it and they want it too. And Lord, we just thank thank you that you are going to use us no matter how old or young we are. And it's in Jesus' strong name that we pray. Amen.